Do you like to kill enemies behind walls without even seeing them? Or maybe take out a roaming super with just a single throwing knife? Well then, I have the exotic for you. Today we're looking at a hunter build using the exotic Athrys' Embrace. I've wanted to cover these gloves for a long time because I truly think they're one of the most fun exotic options for hunters once you get the hang of using them effectively. If you're not familiar with these gloves, the exotic perk is Skittering Stinger, which grants your weighted knife a second bounce. Rapid precision hits grant your knife a significant damage bonus and the ability to stun unshielded enemies in PvE for a short time. You need at least 3 precision hits to proc the perk, and then you get an extra 5 seconds per precision hit until you hit the maximum timer of 30 seconds. The wings on these gloves also have a really cool animation to show you when the perk is activated. It's such a cool little detail. The buff we get with these gloves to our throwing knives is quite substantial, so much so that we can get a kill in PvP with just a single body shot. We can also one-hit kill a super with a throwing knife headshot, and in PvE, these crazy knives deal some beefy damage against yellow bar enemies. More on that later. Since this build is centered around those weighted knives, we'll be on the bottom tree gunslinger hunter way of the sharpshooter. By far, this is the most stylish version of the hunter with those one-hit kill throwing knives and a super that can instantly shut down opposing supers with just a single headshot. My friend CoolGuy did a great in-depth review of the Athrys' Embrace a while back, and I'll link to it in the description. I definitely recommend watching his whole video, but the quick version is that for PvP, the most effective way to use these special knives is to throw them at the ground so that it slowly ricochets to hit another wall, and then it picks up speed on the second bounce and aggressively tracks the target. The tracking on these knives is absolutely hilarious. While capturing footage for this video, I got so many kills on enemies that were around corners and also long after I died where the knives were bouncing around like little aimbots chasing my killer for revenge. Let's take a look at the shopping list for this build, so to speak. First off, we want to get a lot of throwing knives, and trust me, with this build, we're going to be getting our knives back very quickly in many different ways. Second, we want to choose weapons that best synergize with the Athrys' Embrace. That way we can buff our throwing knives to be able to get those one-shot kill body shots even around corners. Third, we want to take advantage of the natural synergies around precision with the bottom tree gunslinger subclass. Here's a quick overview of the perks we get with the Way of the Sharpshooter. Our bottom tree Goldie is all about precision, with your guns, your knives, and your super. Many perks on the subclass directly benefit you for landing precision shots and final blows. The perk Knock 'em Down works kind of like Outlaw, except instead of reload speed, you get stability and handling on a precision kill, and extra kills will extend the buff even longer. This is really nice for some lower stability weapons like 120 RPM hand cannons, and also for players who use controller and maybe struggle a bit to control the recoil. You can get your super very quickly, since precision kills and precision hits grant stacks of Practice Makes Perfect, which speeds up your super recharge rate. Practice Makes Perfect maxes out at 5 stacks and a kill will reward you 2 stacks instead of 1. When it comes to your super, you trade the multi-kill lethality of the Top Tree Golden Gun 6 shooter for the ability to shoot precision shots which can shut down basically any roaming super with a headshot. The shots from this version of Golden Gun also seem a bit more forgiving at range, and they don't have the same damage drop-off issues from the Top Tree Golden Gun. Even in your super, you're rewarded for precision. The perk Line 'em Up will extend your super duration just for landing headshots with your Golden Gun. And the star of this particular build, the weighted throwing knife, is incredibly powerful in the right hands. If you have great aim and you can pre-charge the knife and peek out at just the right time, there's basically no counter to them. The knives also reset and give you another charge if you manage to land a precision kill, so you can go on some pretty crazy sprees with them if you get the technique down. So that mostly covers the subclass perks. Let's think about what weapons synergize best with this build, starting with the primary weapon choice. The first requirement is that we want to build up stacks for Athrys' Embrace as quickly and easily as possible to buff up those throwing knives. This means that we're looking for high rate of fire weapons to land headshots fast. Sorry hand cannons, we're putting you aside for this particular build. I think the first most obvious choice here is to use the Monte Carlo auto rifle. This is an exotic 600 RPM auto rifle with the perk Monte Carlo method. Dealing damage reduces your melee cooldown and has a chance to fully recharge your melee ability. If you remember back to our shopping list, the number one goal of this build is to get a lot of knives, so this is naturally going to be a great pairing. However, as much fun as Monte Carlo can be, in-game it feels a little bit outclassed by some more meta picks like the 120 RPM hand cannons, the Dead Man's Tail, and certain high impact pulse rifles. In practice, I found that I was actually able to build up stacks more safely and consistently with a pulse rifle because I was able to play from a bit further range and peek shot more effectively from behind cover. The first pulse that came to mind was the Messenger, which is one that I reviewed in depth in my last video. I think this is one of the best pulse rifles in the game right now, and certainly the most lethal. However, the slow base rate of fire here just doesn't synergize great with the Athrys' Embrace. For the same reason, we're going to take a pass on the No Time to Explain and any other 340 RPM pulse rifle. These are great options in general, but they just don't satisfy the second criteria in our shopping list as well as some of the other options out there. Looking at the slightly faster firing pulse rifles, there are two that really stood out to me. The first is the Sacred Providence from the Garden of Salvation raid. I think this is one of the stronger non-sunset legendary pulse options at the moment, and it shoots a 4-round burst, which is really nice because it gives us some extra breathing room with that skittering stinger perk on our gloves by extending the timer if we hit a full burst of crits. Since it's a legendary weapon, it also frees up the ability to use an exotic weapon in the energy slot. This is where we can pick the Pulse Shotgun Hybrid Lord of Wolves, which is a great weapon for building up those skittering stinger stacks. Try saying that 5 times fast. Lord of Wolves is a criminally underrated shotgun in my eyes. It was a top pick from a few seasons ago to the point where it was actually oppressively strong, and then it got nerfed, which knocked the usage way down in PvP, but I think it's actually a very strong weapon if you have good aim. Another fun choice here is the Divinity Exotic Trace Rifle. Since this gun paints a crit bubble on the target, you instantly proc those strengthened knives after just a few hits, and then if you throw the knife fast enough while the crit bubble is still on the target, you get your knife back instantly by landing a precision kill. This is really fun, although in more serious play, I think you're probably better off with a shotgun. Finally, I think the strongest weapon that satisfies all of the criteria on our shopping list is actually the Vigilance Wing. This is an S-tier exotic pulse rifle with an incredibly competitive and forgiving optimal time to kill that requires only about 50% headshot ratio depending on the resilience level. The beautiful thing about the Vigilance Wing is that it shoots a nasty 5-round burst, so if you land a full burst of headshots, you're going to earn yourself some extra time to throw those charge up knives. With the rapid flow of headshots, we're also charging our super faster thanks to the subclass perk Practice Makes Perfect. And if we secure a headshot or a body shot kill with the knife, that's even more super energy for us. So with our primary slot chosen to be an exotic weapon, we need to pick something for the energy in the heavy slot. The Vigilance Wing performs best at medium range, and while it's certainly usable up close, I found the best pairing to be a shotgun for close quarters fights. Probably no big surprise there. The standard go-to option, of course, is the Fellwinter's Lie, but if you're not into Fellwinters and you want to try something a bit different, any other shotgun can work just fine here. Also, if you're into slug shotguns, these can pair really nicely with the subclass perks on Bottom Tree Goldie, so maybe give something like the First In Last Out a shot and see how it works out for you. If shotguns aren't really your thing, feel free to experiment with any other type of weapon here as well. This build doesn't really rely too much on specific weapon choices as long as your primary weapon is able to land those rapid headshots to build up stacks on your gloves. You can even run a double primary setup with something like an SMG or a sidearm if that's up your alley. The same goes for your heavy weapon choice. I found the best option to be the Commemoration Machine Gun since landing headshots will charge up your knives, but really anything else is fine here too. One good option for either your special or heavy slot might be to run a weapon with the perk Wellspring, which will get you your knives back a little bit faster on kill. When it comes to your subclass options, I would recommend the Bottom Tree Dodge, Gambler's Dodge, because every time you dodge an enemy, you're going to instantly recharge your melee ability. For your jump options, I prefer Strafe Jump for basically every PvP scenario on Hunter because it allows you to move around the map laterally, but really, you can use whatever jump you like best. For your grenade, I found that trip mines were the most effective option here, but you can use whatever grenade you prefer. More on that in the next section. Let's run through the armor setup and the mod selection with this build. You don't have to copy this exactly by any means, but I'll point out the most important parts so you know where you can be flexible. On my helmet, I'm running shotgun targeting, pulse rifle targeting, and radiant light. Radiant Light here makes my teammates charge with light anytime I cast my super, and it also gives additional plus 20 strength when slotted with another arc mod in your build. Hands-on is also a good option here to give your super back faster from melee kills, which you'll be getting quite a few of if you play this build well. On my gloves, I'm running Pulse Rifle Loader and Momentum Transfer. This mod is really useful on this build in particular to get your knives back. If you're not familiar with it, dealing damage with your grenade grants you melee energy. It's not enough to get your full knife back, but it's a nice bump that can simulate having a few extra tiers of strength. As far as I could tell from testing, each nade type generated the same amount of melee energy, so you can pick whichever grenade is your favorite. Personally, I prefer the trip mines. For my chest, I'm running unflinching pulse rifle aim and taking charge so I can get charged with light just by picking up an orb. For my boots, I'm running shotgun scavenger to get extra ammo, invigoration, which helps reduce my knife cooldown by picking up an orb, and Powerful Friends, which charges my teammates with light anytime I get charged, as well as giving plus 20 mobility stat when it's paired with another arc mod. Finally, for the cloak, I'm running Outreach, which gives a bump to melee energy every time I dodge, and High Energy Fire, which gives a damage boost anytime I'm charged with light. The damage boost here is very powerful, and it makes getting those two burst kills with Vigilance Wing even easier. You might be questioning why I run Outreach on my cloak when I can already dodge next to an enemy just to get my knife back automatically. Great question. The reason here is that many times I'll be close enough to getting my knife back that just a single dodge will give me that last little bit of energy for free. Dodging close enough to enemies to proc the gambler's dodge can put you in a lot of danger, and this way we can play to our mid-range strengths with the Vigilance Wing as much as possible while still charging up those knives faster whenever our dodge is available. As far as the stat split goes, I found the most effective way to play this build was to prioritize mobility, recovery, and strength. Ideally, you want either 90 or 100 for both mobility and recovery, and as much strength as you can get. If you're playing in a lobby full of 120 RPM hand cannon users though, it might make sense to sacrifice a few stat points to hit 50 resilience so you can force those players to hit an extra headshot on you. Also, keep in mind that you're effectively getting more intellect on this build if you're landing your headshots, so don't worry too much if your intellect stat isn't super high. Let's talk about how to play this build most effectively. The gameplay loop here looks something like this. Most of the time, you'll want to be playing at mid-range with a Vigilance Wing, going for headshot bursts and ideally trying to 2-burst your opponent. Once you land enough headshots to proc the perk in your gloves, then you have that knife ready to throw. You can throw it straight at an enemy for a headshot, which will recharge it instantly, and even if you land a body shot instead, it'll still be a one-hit kill. If an enemy ducks behind cover, the incredibly generous aim assist when you have the strength and knives will often earn you a free kill around the corner. It's pretty crazy how effective these knives are at earning some hilarious kills. If you hear an enemy pop a roaming super, you want to first try to build up some stacks by landing headshots on the opponent with your Vigilance Wing, and then go for the throwing knife headshot to take out the super instantly. If you don't have your knife charge up quite yet, you can do a combination of dealing damage with your grenade, picking up orbs, and dodging from afar to earn your knife back quickly. And if you happen to have the opportunity to dodge close to an enemy, you can get your knife back instantly, guaranteed. I found that as fun as it is to go for trick shots, my most consistent kills were from throwing the knife straight at the enemy. If you do choose to go for the bounce, make sure to throw it off the ground first so that it bounces onto a wall and then hopefully tracks onto an enemy. As promised in the intro, these gloves work out pretty great in PvE as well. Sure, they probably aren't an S tier pick in endgame content like Grandmaster Nightfalls, where having an invisible hunter with the Omnioculus can save a bad situation from wiping, but they do deal some significant damage against yellow bar enemies and bosses. The charged up knife deals roughly 3 times the damage of a regular knife, and it also pairs well with damage buffs like 1-2 punch shotguns or divinity for some extreme damage potential. It also has the ability to stagger unstoppable champions, which can free up some options in your build, especially if you're running solo content like Legend or Master Law sector farming. Overall, for both PvP and PvE, this build might not be the strongest option out there for Hunter, but it's certainly one of the most fun builds that I've used in a long time. If you like this video, check out my Chaos Reach Warlock build, which can earn you one of the fastest supers in all of Destiny PvP. It's the video on the top right of your screen as well as in the description.